a lot of kids really like what we do.
Not something we hear too often when it comes to medical therapy, but when the treatment is a video game?
Mightier is a way for children to build emotional regulation skills. It is a video game-based tool. They can be especially helpful for kids with ADHD or autism.
According to founder Dr. Jason Kahn and gaming architect Trevor Stricker, Mightier may just be the almighty solution to helping kids regulate their emotions.
Whoa!
The National Institutes of Health is curious too, funding the company's current video game study.
It puts kids in video games where they naturally get frustrated. When that moment of frustration comes, the game does something a little counterintuitive. It gets harder. Hey, look, your anger, your frustration, it's getting in your way, just like real life. And so we're using video games as a proxy for real life.
This gaming system is the brainchild of Dr. Kahn, who began developing the technique to treat patients at Boston Children's Hospital.
One of the things that we were noticing is that the kids who were coming into the hospital for psychiatry, all of them needed help with emotional regulation skills. We knew that emotional regulation was a superpower that would help those kids.
Kahn created a prototype to help convince Stricker, who has 20 years in video game development, to join him on a new venture.
He's like, well, obviously this stinks, and like, we've got to make something that kids want to play. And I was like, yes, you know, you had me at hello.
Mightier has licensed 27 popular games kids already like to play. They then tweak the format.
We have to integrate Mightier's emotional learning into the gameplay itself.
Strap on a heart monitor.
You just slide it on your arm.
Fire up the tablet.
Right now it's connecting and it's reading my heart rate.
Choose a game. And that is where it gets interesting. The more frustration the player experiences, the harder it is to move forward.
When my heart rate goes up, I enter the red zone. It's harder to play. Look, I can't aim very well.
Calm yourself down.
You can pause the game, and it walks you through deep breathing.
And you are back in play. A method of treatment that this team says will help gamers take control of their own progress.
No kid wants to think that they're different or can't do something. And if you have an opportunity and a place to practice, you're going to get better at it, no matter who you are.
We access it by just opening up.
This machine may look like a game. It even has a cool name, the Swoop. But this is far from play. The device is the newest member of the neurocritical care team at Massachusetts General Hospital.
It completely changes the way we think about MRI imaging. Now we've got a device that we can bring right into a room.
A completely portable MRI. It rolls right to the patient's bedside. Developed by Hyperfine, headquartered in Connecticut, the Swoop received FDA clearance in 2020. The initial inspiration was pediatrics. But it soon became clear that portability could be a critical element in overall critical care.
Critically ill patients, it's hard to move them from their room. They've got infusion pumps, mechanical ventilators, and when you take them off that and take them over to an imaging room, you're moving them out of the support structure that the ICU is designed to provide.
The Swoop uses a magnet system with a lower field strength than traditional MRI, but engineers were challenged by sound.
How do we actually now do image when you don't have shielding? So team invented noise canceling technology similar to noise canceling headphones, where it actually listens to noise in the environment, in electromagnetic noise, not audio noise, and removes it in the image.
So what's the trade-off?
It is not as high resolution as a conventional high field MRI, but it's not designed to replace that.
Asymmetry between caregiver and technology that Dr. Kimberly says is crucial, not only to treating patients, but better understanding of the human body.
Technology is so important for advancing state-of-the-art care and making new discoveries and being able to treat patients that are in our ICU.
And the Swoop is now in more than 70 hospitals, and it's great, of course, that Mass General Hospital is one of them.
And back to Mightier, they're not the only company using video games to help children with medical issues. Back in 2020, another Massachusetts company got FDA approval for a prescription-only video game to help children manage their ADHD.
So cool. All right.